Hello, everyone. I am back in the studio here, and I have Joanna with me, and she is from the Early On program, and I'm going to let her do her own introduction because, like, they cover so much in our local Stratford and Perth area. But tell us all about the Early On program. Introduce us for those that might not know.
Wonderful. Thanks so much, Rebecca. And I'm so happy to be here talking about Early On programs. So as you said, my name is Joanna Osborne. I specifically work in the Stratford Early On programs, but we're also part of Perth Care for Kids, who does programs in the West Perth and Perth East. And then, like you said, there are other programs in Perth County as well. So St. Mary's runs programs up in North Perth area. They run lots of programs up there as well. So, you know, I might be talking about Stratford's programs specifically, but if you're interested in some Early On programs, definitely search out programs in your area, because we all offer very similar types of programs. So I have worked for Early On forever, it feels. I absolutely love working with Early On and families and all those kinds of things. We're located in the Falstaff Family Center in Stratford. So that's 35 Waterloo Street North. Our programs are drop-in. So that's a great part, is that you don't have to worry about pre-registering or signing up. If you wake up one day and you feel like it's going to work for you, you just show up and go to our programs. So that's who I am.
Yeah, amazing. And we all know how mom life is, that, you know, you have a plan, but, you know, the little ones might be not so on board with that day, or, you know, the evening before, where that very lacking in sleep night. So I know that happens a lot. So tell me about what you guys offer there. Like, what are some of the services, the offerings that you guys have for the parent community?
Oh my goodness, so much. It's truly incredible how much Early On programs provide. So I think most people, when they hear Early On, they might not be sure what it is. They think it's just a place where you come and play with your kids. Mm-hmm. And for sure, that's a big part of it. But there's so much more to it than that. I always say that the adults come for the kids, and then they don't realize that they get so much out of it as well. So our programs are, as I said, they're drop-in programs. So you just come to a program to play. It's set up kind of like a daycare room would be. You know, we've got art centers, we've got dramatic play, you know, where the kids can dress up. We've got blocks and, you know, kitchen centers and cooking and all that kind of stuff. So many different areas and things for the kids to do. But when the adults come, kids are just playing, but adults get to connect with other adults. You know, a lot of times they get inspiration of things that they can do at home. You know, yes, we can buy some fancy toys and things like that, but we also use a lot of things that you can just find around your home, because we really want parents to be able to kind of get ideas and get inspiration, and then be able to go home and do that activity with their kids at home. It's like, oh, I didn't realize my child was really into that. And, you know, yeah. Wait a minute, I can do that. You know, like, wait a minute, it's not just something, you know, fancy that we do there. I can do that at home. They also get lots of support with parenting struggles. We know parenting is hard. So when you're coming to a drop-in program, you know, you're talking to other moms, you're talking to the staff. One of our favorite things that we talk about at programs, and I think we all do at all our programs, is something crazy called schemas. And it's just, you know, sort of those typical developmental, you know, sort of things that kids do. And it's always those behaviors that are over and over and over again that really frustrate us as parents. And like, oh, you know, they're doing this again. And so we're able to share, like, oh, actually, that's an age-appropriate behavior that your child is doing. And here's how you can support that. And here's how you can. And so, you know, parents are just constantly learning something new about their little ones.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure, right? It's a never ending, it seems sometimes, right? and I love the community aspect of it, because, you know, now that we're post-pandemic, knock on wood, that we can say that, that, you know, we lost a lot of that in-person connection, and we lost a lot of that community time that our parents could get together and have those conversations, and those going through sleep regressions or, you know, really struggling, and, you know, knowing that there's other mamas out there that are going through the same battles, and, you know, you almost have that peace of mind, right? So I love the community aspect of it, just because it's like for your mama's sanity, right? You know, you just kind of like, you need that.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So what are the clients that utilize your services? I know there's probably a good spectrum of those as well.
Absolutely. Everybody. So that's the thing, is that it's not just for, you know, for moms. You know, we get lots of dads that come out to programs. We get grandparents that come out to programs, caregivers, you know, sort of family members that come. And I mean, we know with the childcare shortage right now, there's a lot of grandparents out there doing childcare. You know, families are so lucky that, you know, to have some of that, those supports. And so it's amazing how many grandparents we get coming out to programs, and even caregivers, who are, you know, sort of at their home. It's isolating for them as well. You know, you're spending your day watching other people's children. You might have those, you know, sort of four or five kids, and it can be hard. You're on your own all day long. So we definitely get lots of caregivers that come out. So really, it's for everybody. We have that open door policy where everybody is welcome.
Yeah. Amazing. So what is your why? Why don't we dive a little bit deeper and get into you a little bit, and tell us about your why. Why do you do this?
Oh, the families. Oh my goodness. So I started out in childcare many moons ago, and I loved it. I loved the children. I loved, you know, sort of interacting with them and caring for the children sort of all day long, and knowing that parents that had to work had a safe place for their kids to go, and that they were being sort of cared for it and nurtured and all those wonderful things. And then I stumbled across EarlyOn, I couldn't believe it. Like, I came in thinking, oh, it's a program for drop-in, you know, for moms that are staying at home. And what about all my, you know, little ones that need somebody to care for them? And I probably was only there a handful of days and went, oh my goodness, this is incredible. So I have my ECE, so I'm a registered early childhood educator. And then I also have a sociology background as well. And I think that's where the EarlyOn really speaks to me, because like you said, it's all about community. We're impacting the family as a whole. So when you walk through that door, you know, the first time, and everybody comes through the door for a different reason, right? Some people are coming just because they want something different to do. They need to fill the day. Some people are coming because they're isolated and, you know, and they're really, you know, sort of looking for that connection to the community. You know, some are struggling with a behavior or, you know, a stage of development, and they're looking for some of those supports. So knowing that when a family walks through the door, we're able to provide, you know, supports and services and things like that for that whole family. And not just the child. So it really is sort of that all encompassing, and just knowing that we're impacting families, you know, we're helping them on their journey, and we're there to support them in whatever they need. So we don't have an idea when you walk through that door, you know, we don't have a checklist of what we're going to provide you. We're going to wait and see what it is that you need and where you're at in your journey, and, you know, and able to support families very sort of on an individual basis, kind of based on what they need. And it's just so rewarding. It's wonderful. I absolutely love, I couldn't imagine doing anything else.
Yeah, absolutely. And I love that you have so much fire and passion, and, you know, that it really fuels you and drives you and sparks you, right? You know, and, you know, like when you're going, it's never a job. It's, you know, something fun to do every day, and getting to see all the littles and how they light up when they come, and how the parents just like, you know, have that sense of, you know, belonging and community. And, you know, like, I love that. That's awesome. So I think we kind of covered the best part of your job in that one, didn't you? Because that was my next question. And it's like, oh yeah, you can see that. So how do you support families postpartum?
Oh, so many ways. So many ways. So really, it can start from day one. So one of the programs that we offer in Stratford, I'm not sure if any of the other ones offer it, but specifically in Stratford, it's called our infant program. And it starts right from, you know, sort of when they're born. I get some moms reaching out even before they've had their baby, you know, sort of asking if they can sign up for the next program. So the infant program is really geared to 0 to 4 months. So it's those moms with brand new babies. Doesn't have to be your first. I always say moms with new babies, not new moms, because we definitely get moms who might be on their second or third child, but it's a unique experience every time. So just because you've had another doesn't mean that you know everything and that it's going to go smoothly. You still struggle. You know, it's still hard. So that infant program is such a passion for me when you think about, you know, your why and the passion, because it's such a unique time in you and your baby's sort of development and that whole experience. And so they come in, it's a place where moms can come and connect to other moms. They can support each other. There's a little bit of an educational component to it. So we have different topics each week. It usually runs between 6 and 8 weeks, depending on where it falls in the calendar. But it's, you know, every week we talk about, have a different topic. I put in a little bit of information, you know, depending on what the topic is, but I really encourage that conversation amongst the moms so that they really get a chance to know each other and to share and support. In that program too, there's so much focus on well-being. We know that those first few more, your hormones are all over the place and, you know, and really you're sleep deprived, you're, you know, there's just so much going on for you in those months that we talk about that idea of not suppressing those feelings. We hear so often, oh, I shouldn't complain. Oh, it's this, oh, I shouldn't complain. It, you know, somebody else might have it so much worse. And I always say, yes, you should complain. It's okay to complain. It's okay to say it sucks. It's okay to say it's hard. It's okay to say you're struggling. The more a mom sort of suppresses all of that and says, oh, you know, oh, I'm fine. Oh, it's not too bad. Then all of a sudden they start, you know, sort of thinking like, oh, I am having a hard time, but I shouldn't be, right? And, you know, so we talk so much about, doesn't matter how big or how small your struggle is, just say it, normalize it, normalize the fact that it's hard, normalize the fact that, you know, you feel like you're a walking zombie and, you know, and all these kinds of things. So, I mean, there's just so much conversation around that in that group. You know, we've had lots of tears and tears are okay. Tears are healthy. You know, we shouldn't be ashamed that, you know, we're crying. We feel like we need to do it at home in the privacy of our home, you know, where nobody sees. And then we go out in public and we, you know, plaster on this smile, like everything is wonderful. And it's not, it's hard, right? And it's okay to say it's hard. So that for sure is one of my sort of babies, and I love that program so much. And it's amazing because I've been doing it for quite a few years now, so it's amazing to see moms and those connections that have been formed. And they might come back, you know, sort of a few years later with a second baby, and they'll say, we still get together, you know, we still, you know, sort of, I've got my little mom tribe, and the number of connections that are made through that, because you get to know each other on a really personal level, and it really helps sort of form those bonds and form those connections. So it's amazing how many moms are out there that are part of a group that have met at that type of program.
Yeah. Oh, I love that. Yeah.
So when you think about postpartum, you know, obviously there's that right after baby, which is the hardest. But we also offer baby time programs, which are usually 0 to 12 months, sometimes in some of the areas 0 to 18 months. And I know all of our locations offer offer baby time programs. So all across Perth County, you can find a baby time program. And it's interesting because sometimes moms will wait until they feel like baby is old enough to come, that baby is old enough to get something out of the program. Maybe wait until they're crawling, you know, wait until they're playing a little bit more with things, because they think that it's for the baby. And I say, oh, no, it's for you, right? It's you. As soon as you are feeling up to getting out of the house and wanting to connect and wanting to, you know, sort of find something to do, come. I had a mom come with a 2-day-old baby one time. She was just that go get her mom. She was like, I am not stay at home. You know, I need to get out and do things. And, you know, and so, yeah, so I said, come, because it's all about you. You're chatting with the other moms. Baby might sleep the entire time you're there. And that's okay, because you're coming to connect with other moms and watch and see what other babies are doing. It's so interesting to see all the different developmental stages, and you're like, oh, that's what's coming next. Or, oh my goodness, look what they're doing. And, oh, I can't wait. You know, you get to see all of that happening. Most of the baby time programs involve some singing, so have a little bit of a circle time. I know you've done some fitness programs with some of the programs as well. So there's so much to those baby time programs. So definitely, as soon as you as a mom are feeling, you know, sort of well enough to get up, and, you know, physically well enough to get up and out of the house, don't worry about being emotionally well enough to get up in the house. That's why you go, right? You go to help out with that emotional piece. And if you're having a tough day and you feel like you're just, you know, sort of crying and about everything, that's more reason to go, right? More reason to go and get out and connect and get those supports. So yeah, so you know, be physically healthy, physically well enough to go out, because it's draining trying to get out of the house. But definitely, you know, if you're having a tough time, please go to a program, because they definitely help with that. So yeah, and that's just our baby time programs.
Yeah, I love that. And I love, like, how you said to come. And I say that with my stroller fit mamas as well, too. I'm like, if you're having a rough day, come. If you haven't got any sleep, come. If baby's fussing, come. You know, it's better, you know, we're all moms. We've been there. We know that babies are going to fuss. They're going to cry. But isn't it better to be around other people and not feel like lost in that pit of despair sometimes that we get, and overwhelmed, and, you know, just don't know what to do, when you can have some extra support around you and from other people that have been through all of that, you know, at some point of their parent journey. You know, life isn't perfect. Life is messy. And, you know, like, we will take you no matter what you look like. You know, if you've got the mom bun and your socks don't match and you put your shirt on inside out, it's all good, you know, just like
get up on the shoulder.
Right? Yes. And I love that, because, you know, we need that type of not social media savvy perfection looking, because that's not real life. You know, we've all, you know, have been kind of brainwashed a little bit by the magazines and stuff and in the past. But I think now, like, you know, we're definitely shedding more light on what real life really looks like. And, you know, seeing all the beautiful bumps. I just saw pictures of Blake Lively showing off her beautiful baby bump for number 4. Good for her, mama. And, you know, she's in her jammies, you know, she's in a bathrobe and she's tired. And it's just like, yes, this is real life. This is real mom life. You know, it's not easy peasy. It's not, you know, walk in the park all the time. You know, sometimes it has great moments and sometimes it doesn't. But I love that. I think that's such an important point, is that, you know, just come as you are. We take you any which way, shape, or form. And I think for new parents, I'm finding, especially in the Stratford area specifically, we're getting an influx of new families into the area, and it's so hard to find, you know, parents and make those mom connections and make your own little mama tribe and, you know, finding your group. And when I say mama, I mean parents as well, not just mamas, but, you know, finding those other parents out there that, you know, have similar interests and backgrounds or similar children at different, the same stages that you can make those connections with. And I think that's super important to have programs like this for those new parents to the communities and the areas so that they can find, you know, and make those connections. And it's intimidating to come out to something new and trying something new, right? You know, like, we got to put it on our big girl panties and try to, you know, put ourselves into a new and an unusual situation, especially when you've just moved into a community. But having such a great program like yours, where, you know, it encompasses so many things, and it is just a drop-in, so you can just come when it works for you. But such a great way to connect with other people and like-minded individuals, and those in the same, you know, position that you are as a parent, right? You know, it's like, absolutely. We get you. We're there.
We have had so many moms come, and we'll be introducing, and well, we just moved to the area, and, you know, and I think, oh, wonderful. Like, let's introduce you over here, and, oh, have you met so-and-so? And, you know, sort of helping. Yeah. It's nice to have somebody, you know, sort of to help facilitate that, you know, that connection. You know, you can't do it at the mall, you know, it's quite so easy, but, you know, coming where you've got somebody. And it's so funny, because when a parent comes the first time, especially to the baby time program, where you're coming in and everybody's kind of sitting in a circle, and you walk in and you feel like everybody knows each other, I always say it feels like high school all over again. You're walking into a and you're the new kid, and you feel like everybody probably knows each other, and you're the odd one out. And, you know, so I would say, you know, everybody here is probably met here. You get the odd person. Once in a while, you get friends that are coming together, you know, because they've had babies at the same time or whatever. Mm-hmm. But majority of time, people that might be close friends now have met at a program, right? So, you know, so don't hesitate to walk up and introduce yourself, you know, if your kids are playing close by, you know, sort of say who you are and things like that. But whenever I say, you know, that it feels like high school, like, yes, you know, you're so right. It so does. It's hard. It's so hard. But once you come once, you're like, okay, I know where to go. I know, you know, sort of what to expect, and, you know, that all that pressure and all that, you know, it just sort of comes off that. You know, and you were saying, you know, how we support moms postpartum, you know, the infant programs and the baby time are just one of what we do. You know, we also have our regular drop-in play and learns, which are 0 to 6. So you might have a mom with 2, and she's on her sort of second or third or fourth, like Blake. and, you know, and you're back on mat leave again, and now all of a sudden you've got your other ones who maybe were in daycare, and now you're at home all of a sudden with them again, you know, with this new baby. And, oh, it's so great to be able to get out and give something for the older one to do. Now that, like you said, knock on wood, we're kind of getting to post-pandemic, staff are always helpful, you know, so happy to hold babies, because sometimes it's, you know, sort of having a staff hold the baby so that you have some one-on-one time with the older child, because the baby takes up so much, and they don't get quite the same sort of one-on-one that they had sort of before a baby, and are feeling like a little bit, you know, sometimes you see those behaviors because, you know, they're seeking that connection. So, you know, for a staff to hold a baby so that you can, you know, sort of interact with your older one, or, you know, or if you're nursing, or, you know, sort of taking care of baby, you know that there's somebody around, and it's amazing to watch the other parents. One day I was in program, there was about 5 or 6 families, and I was looking around the room, and I don't think a single parent was with their child. Like, the kids were all over the place, and like every parent was playing with somebody else's child. It was hilarious. I thought, well, here's our village. You right? know, they say it, it's a village. And it's like, look at this. I said, you know, somebody's reading a book to somebody else's child, somebody else's. And I mean, that's just so wonderful to see, you know, that again, if you've got a little one at home, you know, a baby and a toddler, older ones, to be able to get out to some of those. And we even have some of our moms with those older babies. So they might be kind of that, you know, sort of 10 months and, you know, they're busy now, they're crawling and, you know, they're much more tiring now because they don't stay in one spot. And, you know, and so they'll come to our 0 to 6 programs as well. And because they're like, oh, they love watching the big kids. And they love talking to a mom just this past week. And she came out to a 0 to 6 program for her first time. And she's like, that was so much fun. She's like, why didn't I come sooner, you know, to the older ones? And I said, the baby time is all about mom, and the older one, you know, really is getting to watch them play and interact and things like that. She's like, exactly. You know, it was so much fun. So yeah. So we tell moms all the time, like, yes, the baby time and the infant program are specifically for, you know, those age groups. But if you need out of the house, if you're having one of those days and you're like, I need a change of scenery, I need people, I maybe need a little bit of support, come to any program, right? A mom with a baby is always welcome at any of our programs. So, you know, don't feel like you need to wait for that age specific one. So, you know, get out of the house and come, right? And we have virtual programs a lot as well. So I know for our Perth Care for Kids, so for our Stratford and West Perth, we have a YouTube channel with songs and stories and things like that. So if you're wanting to learn some songs to sing with baby, you can check those out. A lot of our sort of centers, I know between Perth Care for Kids and St. Mary's and North Perth, we all use social media a lot. So we'll post ideas and tips and things like that. And then Perth Care for Kids also has, it's a closed parenting group. So it's Perth Care for Kids parenting support. And we post a lot of information on that parenting page as well. So moms can join that as well we've been doing it a while now, and there's so many resources on that page now.
We needed it, right? And that's the nice thing about that. One of the good things out of the pandemic is the way that the virtual world has really changed, that we've really utilized it more as a tool and a resource option for, you know, different programming and different options to allow for, you know, parents that maybe just can't get out of the house, you know, like they, you know, have restrictions or only a single vehicle family like myself, you know, so I don't always have a car home to be able to go off and do things, or I'm not within walking distance. So there's a lot of limitations, but being able to have options and finding resources and things online that you can help with entertaining. And YouTube is just such a vast, and Facebook as well too, right? You know, it's great to have those connections and, you know, being able to meet other moms that maybe have the same predicament as well too, and creating opportunities for themselves to, oh, well, let's go for a mummy walk on this day together and things like that, and make those connections, which I think is so important as well too.
Absolutely.
So how do we get in touch with you? How do we find you? How do we reach you? How do we register to join? What's like the whole process and the best way to go about all of those?
Yeah. So like I said, most of our programs are drop-in. So I would say that social media, I think websites, all of our different locations do have a website. So if you're not a social media person, you can access our calendars on our websites as well. But definitely social media is the fastest way. All of our pages have, so there's a Stratford Early On page. I know there's a West Perth Early On page, Town of St. Mary's, North Perth. We all have Early On, so social media pages where we post our monthly calendars. So you just sort of check out the calendar and see what's happening on a particular day. And most of them will say play and learn. So if you see the title play and learn, that's our, all of our 0 to 6. We try to keep are the names of our programs as consistent as possible, sort of throughout Perth County, so that if you are looking for a program, you kind of know, okay, play and learn looks the same and is going to be the same sort of wherever I go. Same with the baby time programs and things like that. And the other thing too, is that if you live in St. Mary's, but you come to Stratford for the day, or you're going to be, I mean, you're welcome to join programs anywhere within the county, even if you're outside of county. I mean, we get families that come from New Hamburg, we get families that come from, you know, sort of Tavistock, and, you know, we're families that are visiting. So you don't have to live in Stratford to attend a Stratford program. Everybody is welcome. So check the calendar for when a program is, and most of them, if they're, say, a 2-hour program, so if it says that it's our 9 to 11:30, that's drop in. So you come whenever during that time that it fits you and your baby's schedule. So we get some who are right early birds because their children have been up since 6 o'clock and they're ready to do something. And so they'll be there right for 9. But then by 10:30, their child is ready for, you know, a late morning nap or something like that. Or they've got an errand to run or an appointment or whatever. So, you know, they might come at 9 and leave by 10. Others might come at 10 and stay right till we close, you know, at 11:30. So you just come and go during whatever the scheduled time is on the calendar. Based on when it fits your little one's schedule. You might come at 9:30 planning to stay till 11:30, and halfway through the morning, you're like, ooh, it's time to go. They start rubbing their eyes. They start, you know, sort of having your temper tantrums and all those kinds of things. And, you know, and reading those cues, you know, reading your little one's cues of when they're ready to leave a program. And some will come and stay the entire time. So it's just drop in. And that's a nice part about drop in. Usually if there's a program that's pre-registered, so like our infant program, we do as a pre-registered program. And it's usually just by email. So again, all of our social media have email addresses and things that, or Messenger or whichever. You can reach out. I know you'll be providing some contact information for parents. So we can provide the Stratford email address. We can actually, even if you're sort of typing out and putting that in, we can maybe even add email addresses for all the locations, so that if somebody is looking for some information in a specific area, then they can reach out to those.
Yeah, for sure. We'll make sure to put in all the links and all the information into the group and then into the podcast as well, too. So, yeah, make sure that everybody can get in touch. But, yeah, amazing. Was there anything else that you wanted to add today?
Oh,
I know we covered a lot.
I know there's so much. My staff always joke that I can talk for hours. I was trying to keep it down. I think one of the things that I always think, especially when I think back to that infant program, and I think about those really new moms, that it's interesting in our society, there's some little words that people use that are really hard as a mom to hear. So I always have in part of our infant program too, it's little tidbits, little words that, you know, that we share just to kind of help any mom, not even new moms, but any mom sort of on that parenting journey. So there's two that I'll share with moms today. So one is the word just. So if I could eliminate the word just from, you know, sort of parenting vocabulary, because well-meaning people giving advice, giving support, whatever, they'll say, oh, just do this, oh, we'll just put them down on their back, just do this, just take it away, just, you know. And unfortunately, the word just really sort of minimizes the struggle, minimizes how hard it can be. So if you as a mom are struggling and somebody says, well, you know, sort of just put them to sleep, you know, sort of in their crib. And you're thinking, but I can't, why can't I do that? Why is that hard for me? Why, you know, if I should just be able to do that and I can't, you know, that then there's, you know, that's when that self-doubt comes in and we start questioning questioning ourselves, and then we struggle. So, you know, when we hear, it's just a cue. So when we hear that word just as a parent, and we go to that place of now sort of self-doubt and second guessing ourselves and all those kinds of things, we can stop and say, wait a minute, it's not just. They're trivializing how easy it is. They're trivializing, you know, the process. And so it just allows us to filter out that word, right? And knowing that it's not just, you know, as easy as putting them down to sleep or putting them down awake. And, you know, nursing, they always say, oh, well, you know, sort of nurse, but make sure you're putting them to bed, you know, drowsy and all the thing. So yeah, my other word is should. So when people are shoulding on you, that's my, you can say, oh, well, you really should do this. You really should do that. Again, it creates a doubt. We start second guessing ourselves. We start questioning choices that we're making and it might even be a professional saying, oh, well, you really should, you know, sort of be doing this. We're like, oh, should I? Like, why should I? And we, you know, we get to that place. So if somebody is shoulding on you, you simply ask, oh, that's interesting. Can you tell me why? Have the other person justify their answer. Have the other person, you know, justify the or rationalize why they're suggesting why you should do something. And then you can evaluate whether or not it makes sense to you or not. I even had a mom, you know, after an infant program, when we talked about this, she had gone to the doctor, she was nursing, she had a big baby, was, you know, over 9 pounds when he was born, and he was a healthy eater. And the doctor was telling her that she should probably start, you know, sort of introducing some formula. So she's like, wait a minute, Joanna said to ask why. So she did. So she says, oh, like, can you tell me why you feel like I should introduce formula? And so the doctor said, oh, well, they're, you know, they're probably eating all the time. Like, they're, it's probably really draining for you and really hard. And they're like, no, actually, they're a really good eater and efficient and everything's going well. And so the doctor said, oh, well, then you don't need to. But it was just, it was amazing. She felt so empowered by being able to ask that why, instead of feeling that self-doubt, instead of questioning her choices, instead of doing something that maybe didn't feel right to her because somebody was telling her she should. So yeah.
What a great empowerment. Yeah. What a great empowerment. I love that. Yeah. And I think, you know, we as moms need to follow that intuition a little bit more as well too, and ask those questions, because, you know, sometimes we're like, oh, I can't, you know, I don't want to rock the boat, or I don't want to ask questions and be like a difficult parent or anything, right? But sometimes if you're just like, but should I, you know, like, maybe ask, you know, should I, like, why should I, you know, being you know, inquirative on things like that. I think that's super important. I love that. The just and the should. Yeah. Amazing. I am so glad that you jumped on with us today to have a little conversation, a big conversation about everything that you do. I love the Early On program. I'm a big fan. I've always been a big fan with all four of my children. And I really appreciate you taking the time to chat with us today, Joanna.
Oh, well, thank you for having me. I appreciate being able to talk about it too.
Yeah, for sure. My pleasure.